Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Well, it's been such a long time, almost a year since I have posted a video, but I must tell you, it's been really crazy. It's been a blessing, but it has been really crazy. I started some other businesses, or businesses that we started last year. They grew six figures, and life has just been good. We're so blessed, we're so grateful, and we're so thankful. And so I decided to restart my YouTube channel because I wanted to come and give you guys a ton of value, and I wanted to motivate you to take that step, take that leap, take that you know, that trust and that belief in yourself that you can do this. Let 2021 be the year that you create your financial freedom, that you create your abundance, that you break the generational cycles that has been plaguing you and your family, and that you break the monetary restraints that have been placed on your finances. Okay, good. So let's jump right into it. Today we're going to be talking about how to make 10K selling custom doormats. For those of you who I coach and those of you who has been on my one-on-one calls, you know that I do a lot of sourcing for my clients. And so one of my clients came to me a couple months ago and she wanted to start a custom doormat business. And let me tell you, I did some research and I came across an Instagram page, and the entrepreneur, she was selling custom doormats, but she brought a twist to it. What she was doing is that she was having paint and sip, but painting doormats. And let me tell you, she sold out every single month. She is doing high six figures. And let me tell you, this was just a brilliant idea. And I had to come to you guys and let you know how you can get in, how you can start your own custom doormat business. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay. So, for those of you who are new to my channel, I'm Shade. I'm an online business manager, I'm a business strategist, and I'm also a business consultant. I help people start their e-commerce businesses. I do sourcing for companies, and I run an online business manager company. And so, I provide virtual assistance to businesses, and I also do operational management for a lot of e-commerce businesses. So I'm that, you know, I ensure that these businesses run like a well-oiled machine, and I do sourcing as well for e-commerce businesses. So yeah, I help you start your own business, source hot selling products, and how to get your items branded so you can create your own brand and scale to six figures and higher. All right, so let's talk about sourcing. Whenever I'm sourcing, I typically use two platforms. And so that's AliExpress and that's Alibaba. And Alibaba is really for wholesale and bulk buying. They don't do retail. And AliExpress is retail and they do some wholesale. And the reason I use these two platforms is because 90% of United States businesses go to China for their products and they get them branded. And so you're able to buy cheap and sell high. And that is how you're able to see a super normal profit, right? And this is how you're able to scale your business, because your cost of goods sold is typically low when you source from these overseas companies, right? Okay, so what are the pros and cons of using these two platforms? For Alibaba, they're reliable. I have had some good relationships with the suppliers. I'm always assigned an account manager. The suppliers are vetted, so you're able to search by order of rank, right? And these companies pay to be a part of Alibaba because it's a recommended platform, and you know it's reliable and has a certain stigma attached to it. They also offer free shipping. They typically use like DHL, FedEx, or there is another one I can't remember, but they typically have say 5 to 7 day shipping. you are able to get lower prices when you buy, when you make bulk purchases. In Ali, for, on AliExpress, it has been unreliable at times, but what I do with AliExpress, I look for trending things. So with AliExpress, you're able to see trending products, and then I go over to Alibaba to source those products. Not all the suppliers are vetted and trustworthy. I have purchased from AliExpress, and I've not gotten my items, or the wrong items have came, or they are lost in the mail. There is no personal contact. You're not able to get like an account manager, and they have longer shipping times. Their shipping times are like 30, 60, 90 days, right? And also because they sell retail, the prices are generally higher for one, per item. So my goal is always to go with, my preferred choice is always to go with Alibaba, but you must always do your due diligence. Don't take my word for it. I'm just telling you what I do personally. Okay, so before we get into ordering and running this custom mat, design business, there are some first steps, right? You need to have your business name. What is your business going to be called? You need to have your website up and running. And don't overthink this process. Websites are can be easily done by you, and you don't need to be paying $1,800 to start your business to get a website up and running. Your domain name, for those who don't know, your domain name is, for example, say you're going to call yourself Custom Footprints. If that's going to be your business name, your domain name would be www.customfootprints.com, right? And so typically, why I have the domain name after the website is generally when I build the website, especially using Shopify or Wix, I'm able to just purchase my domain within those platforms. Some persons go ahead and they purchase their domain on GoDaddy because it's like $2 or $4 or whatever. Whenever you use Wix or Shopify, it's typically going to cost you between $14 and as much as $50 per year though. So it's just a yearly payment that you would make. And also, those two platforms, they give you a business email with a domain name. So say you want to have like your customer service department, right? They once you use those two platforms, you're able to get like an info at customfootprints.com or sales at customfootprints.com. So that is why I love those two platforms. And don't most importantly, you need your social media pages. Let me tell you what's going to be great for this type of business, TikTok, hands down. You have to have a TikTok page, you need an Instagram page. Facebook, not so much, but and I would say Twitter pages too, but the two main pages that you need to be on right now for your business is Instagram and TikTok. All right, so let's move over. So registering your business. I during my consultations with a lot of clients, they've always asked me, can I start my business without registering it, or do I have to register first? So, from my personal experience, this is what I'm going to give you. It typically costs between $125 to about $225 to register your business. Any business that I have started, I always started first. And when I start, when the cash, the inflow of the cash starts coming in, that's when I go ahead and register my business. So you can register your business before if you want to protect the business name, but I always do a search on uspto.gov just to see that the name is available. If you're in Florida, you go on to SunBiz, and I check these two platforms just to make sure that the business names are available, and then I go ahead and just start operating. I check also Instagram, I check Facebook, TikTok, just to make sure no other businesses, sorry, has those names, right? And so once the social media platforms are clear with those business names and I realize it's available on uspto.gov or sunbiz.org, I typically just go ahead and register my business, because once I create my business on Shopify with that business name, no other businesses can get that business name. All right. And so now the big questions that I have gotten from a lot of people, and because I have a lot of clients and students that are outside of the US, if they can register their business living outside of the US. And yes, you can. I have registered a lot of businesses for my clients and they live outside the US. You're able to get your LLC. You're able to get your ITIN, which is a tax number. You're also able to get your business bank account. And this is so important, because if you live in the Caribbean, you live in Europe, you live anywhere outside of the US, you can register your business and you can benefit from all the available resources from having a business registered in the US. You can get business credit, you are able to get business loans, you're able to get credit cards from, you know, under your business name. So I always encourage people, if you live outside the US, you need to register your business. If you're in the US as well, you don't have to register right now, but you still need to register your business, right? Just getting started, you don't need to register your business, but eventually you need to, so that you can use business credit to start other businesses, to invest into your business, to grow and scale your business. Credit is a good thing, people. Credit runs America. And so you need to be taking advantage of the opportunities and the resources of using credit. People have used business credit to start to purchase Airbnbs, start their online car rental business with Toro. They have started other businesses. They've got purchased warehouses. They've increased their stock turnover. So guys, register your business. And so I think I answered that question before. Do I need to register my business before I create a website? And that's no. All right. So let's move on. The best websites for your online business. So I mentioned Shopify, which is my number one selection. Then there's Wix, and then there's Ecwid or Big Cartel. Shopify's average cost is $29.99. Wix is $24. I stand corrected, but it's not past $25. Ecwid or Big Cartel is around $10 to $15. So if you're on a tight budget and you want to start your business for less than $100, using these you can use these platforms, Ecwid or Big Cartel. Okay, so where to order? We're going to talk about that. So now that you've gotten your website, you've gotten your business name, you've established your social media pages, where are you going to order your products from, right? And so I did some sourcing, and based on what my customer used the last time, this was our top supplier. And you can see, I told you Alibaba is verified. So you'll see this supplier has been operating for over 6 years. They're verified and they have a gold star rating. So this is a really good supplier. So this is what I use to determine if I'm going to be using this supplier. Okay. All right. So how are you going to make 10K selling these mats? So the average product cost for these mats is $2.90, and their MOQ is 200. So you're looking at $580 to get 200 pieces in. But hold on, you may not have $580 to spend right now. That is fine. Listen, what you're going to do first, you're going to make a sample order. So you're going to make a sample order of about 10 or so, and then with that sample order you're gonna play with different fonts. So if you saw the font that was on the first slide, it says "bitch don't wear no shoes in my house," you can literally tell them what it is that you want to be printed on those mats. And so when you order 10, you're going to negotiate. You're going to tell them that you're just starting out. You need a sample order and you need to have the custom designs on 10 of these. And so when you get these 10 mats, you're going to use them on your website. You're going to use them for promo. you're going to do everything with those 10 mats. And so once your orders start coming in, you are literally going to let people know that, okay, custom orders take 2 weeks to fulfill. So once you start getting those orders in, you can either sell the one you have, or once you have like 10 orders or so, you're able to then place an order, right? So the hardest part for you would be to do your promotion and get, the engagement up on your page and get people purchasing. But you literally can do this. You can do this within a month. Okay, so some people are going to ask, what happens if I only get one order? Well, if you get one order, it would be for one of the mats that you already have. And so you would have already taken, you have to, ensure that you take care with the mats when you're taking your picks for promo and stuff like that. You're going to sell that one mat. With that one mat, you're going to ask that customer to send you pictures of them with their mats and whatever. You're going to use it as a testimonial. And then you're just going to repeat the process and, you're going to say now on your website, you're going to put it out of stock, but available for pre-order. So you're going to create the scarcity to say, oh my God, we sold out in one day. Pre-order now so that you don't get left behind. You really have to understand the psychology of scarcity. So you're going to make it seem like you're getting sold out, and so people don't want to get left behind. So you're going to get 10 orders, 20 orders, 30 orders, and then you'll be able to make your bulk purchase. And so you can always negotiate. Never look at the MOQ as a turnoff. Use it to say, okay, hey, I can, my business is growing. Can I do 20? Can I do 30? So the price might be a little bit more than the $2.90 if you're buying less, but at least you're able to, get 10 or 20 and spend less to start the business. So the shipping costs varies. So shipping cost is typically between $75 and $180, and this is utilizing DHL or FedEx. So you always have to add that to your product costs. And so using this example, the total cost of the product would be 760. So this is 760 to get it at your door, at your home, right? I haven't taken into consideration what it's going to cost you for packaging, and you really don't have to go all out with this. You can order, go online onto USPS, create your account for your business, and order all the shipping products for free. You're able to get packages, you're able to get things that can fit your mat for free, all the boxes and stuff like that. So that is what you use for now. So you have to minimize all your expenses as best as possible. So using this example, our total cost of the product is 760, which means that the cost per unit is $3.80. If I sell 400 mats at $25, my revenue is $10,000. And you can literally sell more than this. You just have to promote your business. You have to be committed. You have to show up every day. You have to post every day. You have to engage every day. So don't be afraid to, go to the mall, go to the plazas and stuff like that, and put your mat there and take a TikTok video and just post it. Just do whatever you need to do. Put it outside your bedroom door, put it outside your home. Just do as much as you can with your product that you have. And believe me, you'll get the engagement that you're looking for. All right. So, we've come to the end of our video. So, if you missed the supplier that I showed before, and I'm trying to keep these videos as short as possible just to give you the information so that you can be up and running. I don't want to bore you with a long ass video and you're not getting any value from this. So if it is that you weren't able to catch the supplier information, you can just email us at thebusinessman5@gmail.com. So yeah, I hope I gave you a ton of value, guys. I hope this is helpful. This gave you some clarity. And I hope I motivated you somewhat to start your own business. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below if this video gave you some value. All right, have a good day. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for our next video. I have a lot of suppliers coming for you, so turn on that notification bell and let's make some money in 2021. Bye.